Fuck off, you bruised dog. I can't get up.
Lay back, relax.
But I can tell you straight, it ain't no game, baby. Oh, God bless me. God help me. Oh, I think I'm insane. Ah, God bless me.
Hi, guys. Welcome to my channel. So, I do have to introduce myself. My name is Deja. Some people call me Daisy, Dage. D, not Big D, because we finna change that. But I am Deja, and I've decided to vlog my VSG journey. So I am from Alabama. I'm 26 years old right now. I turned 27 this year, and I finally decided to go ahead and have the surgery. I've tried to lose weight multiple times throughout the years. I post pictures, but in 2018 is when I got to my highest weight, and that was 289. And I knew then that it was like, okay, girl, what you doing? Get it together. So, I mean, since then, I've just been trying different things. I work out for about 2 to 3 months, see some results, stop. Start back. It's just like back and forth. And so I need a tool that can help me maintain the weight loss, keep it off, and just start a healthy lifestyle. I've did my research over the years, and VSG just seems like the right place to go for me, or the right route to go for me. My mom had the surgery back in, when did she have surgery? I think it was like 2011. I was still in high school at the time. So I kind of know firsthand like the do's and don'ts. And exactly how the surgery works and things like that. And I'm just using my phone just as a guide on what we're gonna talk about today. So my surgery was initially scheduled for January the 12th. And because of COVID, it has been postponed. Bummer. Like, I started my pre-op diet December 29th. So I was like on the strict pre-op diet, which consists of 2 protein shakes for breakfast, lunch, and then for dinner you can have a protein meat and one non-starchy vegetable. So I was doing that for 2 weeks straight, you know, thinking, okay, I'm good. I'm in my final appointment. I made my last payment, and I go back to see the doctor, and they like, you know, you get your final approval, you know, you're excited, you're happy, you're ready to go. Then his nurse comes in and she's like, have they told you what's going on with Huntsville Hospital? And I'm like, no. And I already knew then once they said that, it's like, oh God, like, what is it going to be? Well, with COVID, we had a really huge spike here in Alabama. And they actually postponed all elective surgeries. And if you don't know what elective means, elective is basically like any surgery that's not life-threatening. And being that VSG is not life-threatening, then my surgery was postponed to send those nurses in the surgical unit to different parts of the hospital to help, you know, like different shifts, different areas that was getting flooded with COVID patients. So I totally understood. I just hate that it happened. Well, they changed my diet from 2 protein shakes to a meat and a non-starchy vegetable. They changed that to where I could have 2 full meals and 1 protein shake a day. So I was like madly discouraged, upset, like pissed, baby. I was pissed. So I said I was gonna go have me a real meal. So that's what I did. So like the entire weekend of the 6th, I ate whatever I wanted. Screw that diet. I'll get back on the diet when they call me. So like the following week, you know, I'm like, okay, well, let me kind of get back on the diet because I didn't want to gain any weight. Because your doctor does give you a number to lose. Greatly, my number was only 7, so I had to lose 7 pounds before surgery. So I didn't want to gain any more weight because I had already lost that for the surgery. So I got back on my diet, and they actually called me this past Friday. I was asleep. They woke me up, scheduled my surgery for tomorrow, January 24th. I'm getting VSG surgery, y'all. So I'm finally going to have my surgery tomorrow. I have to be at the hospital at 6 a.m. And I just want to vlog this entire experience. One, because I know other YouTubers, Instagrammers, TikTokers, y'all have helped me so much throughout this process. I've literally been watching y'all's videos for 2 to 3 months now. So it's like, if I can help someone in the way that y'all have helped me, definitely want to do it. So I'm going to vlog my entire experience from now all the way up forever. I'm going to give y'all the need to know, the lowdown, dirty, unfiltered, uncut. I'm going to give it to you raw, baby. I'm going to tell you the do's and don'ts. I'm going to tell you everything. I know my biggest concern was alcohol after this surgery, because your girl is a connoisseur. Period. I drink, baby. So I'm going to see, you know, how it works with alcohol. I saw this other YouTuber, and she actually started drinking like 2 months after surgery. I don't think I'll do it that soon, but I am going to Cancun in March. So we're going to see. I don't think I'll do it that soon. And she said the difference with her was she took a shot and was like drunk. Like drunk. And she sounded like me, like she knew how to drink. So that might be my concern, because once I start drinking, I can't stop. And it's like the more drunk I get, the more drunk I want to be. So we're going to work on that, but we definitely going to try it out on down the road. I'm definitely not going to try it too soon, just for health reasons. And y'all, disclaimer, I am not a medical professional. I am a bio major at MU22. Your girl going to be out there in December. But I am not a medical professional, so all of this is just from personal experience and personal preference. Everybody is different. Everybody's body is different. And everybody have different views on things. So this is just my view of the entire process. So I hope y'all stick around. Like, comment, subscribe to your girl. And we're going to keep this thing going throughout the years, baby. Period. So the first thing we're going to do, we're going to get into the overnight bag. Now my doctor, Dr. Malapur, here in Huntsville, Alabama, he has figured out how to do this surgery. Well, we can be outpatient. Babe, we're doing our surgery. We're going to be in recovery a few hours, and then we're going home. So that's the expectation I'm going into the surgery with. If everything goes smoothly, I'm going to be back at home tomorrow night, and I'm going to show y'all, you know, how we go, how I'm feeling. I already know I'm having some pain. So what he does is 24 hours before your surgery, you do start Tylenol extra strength. So every 6 hours, I'm having to take 2 Tylenols. And I guess that kind of helps prepare your body for the trauma and the pain that you're going into. But definitely is already starting that. And then we get into my overnight bag in case I have to stay overnight. The first thing I got, y'all know, I got my teddy bear slippers, because period. I like hospital socks, but I don't like hospital floors. So I got my teddy bear house shoes in case I have to stay, because homegirl don't want to stay for real. I have some Lysol wipes for everywhere I go, everything I touch. Y'all, I don't play about this COVID at all. Like, don't want COVID. I had it 2020 when it first came out. I had mine for Thanksgiving. Homegirl had to eat by herself. Not going down that road ever again, period. This is something my doctor suggests I get, and it is a hot and cold reusable pad. And it comes with a strap. So if you want it cold, you simply put it in the freezer. If you want it hot, you throw it in the microwave for 20 seconds. And it comes just like this. This scraps around the back, just like that. And he said that this is good for like the wounds and the cuts. I have 5 incisions, and this is really good for the pain management on my incisions. So I'm definitely taking this with me, and I'm gonna have my nurse or anybody to warm it up before I leave the hospital, whether I'm staying or not, because I definitely want to ride home with this, because I've heard stories about the ride home. Hitting bumps or anything can really hurt the incisions. So I got this for the ride home. You know, you gotta have your fresh socks. So I got some fresh socks for the hospital. I got some fuzzy socks. I love my fuzzy socks, y'all. And these come with like the little things at the bottom. So if I just need to hop out the bed real quick and go to the bathroom, I'm gonna have my socks on. And also the hospital socks too. But your girl independent, so I got my own. And this is just like my travel bag. Yeah, I take this like on trips, airports, stuff like that. It's just a small travel bag. It has my baby oil, my Dove Sensitive, my witch hazel for my face, because period. A small thing of Dr. Bunner's and some mouthwash. Y'all, this thing, I think this is like the leftovers from my Colorado trip. I think I might upload that video as well because your girl likes to travel. So this is going to be like a mix between a travel and a VSG journey. But, oh, and I do have. I got some braids right now, but I do have too. So this might be like a little mix little channel. But the primary purpose of this channel is definitely going to be my VSG journey. So I got my little personal bag too. I got me a nice little cute house gown from Walmart, just so your girl can throw that on. Because they said you're going to have to get up and walk and stuff after you have your surgery. So I got this just to throw on and walk around the hospital. Excuse me, don't got COVID. Don't look at me like that. But I also got my robes on the other side of the room. But I got my robe too. It's one of them big fancy robes, y'all, with a little fur on the hands and collars and stuff. You know how I do, real extra. But I got my robe too, just because I need to cover up. Your girl got her Jergens lotion. Gotta keep my Jergens. This is not a paid sponsor seal, but if y'all trying to get some money or y'all want to pay me, then what's up? But I got my Jergens. I also got my hair ties around my Jergens because I never lose them if they with my lotion. I always have my lotion. I have some Tylenol disposable packs. I don't know if y'all know, but after surgery, the only thing that can go in your stomach is liquids, literally. Like, no pills, no tablets, nothing has to be liquids or either, like, something that's broken down. So, Tylenol made disposable packets. It's still the same, you know, milligrams. It's 500 milligrams. It's still extra strength and everything like that. But it's, like, powder instead of the actual tablet. You won't be able to take tablets for like 2 weeks after surgery. So definitely be mindful about that. You can look them up. They have my Amazon. My doctor actually has a bariatric bag that we can go and pick up from my medical mom. And in that bag, you have these, the Tylenol disposable packets. You have this. And this is Gavilax. This is a laxative. I don't know if y'all been watching other VSG videos, but being constipated is a thing. You will be constipated. Your girl gonna be ready. Cause who? I'm gonna sit on that toilet, baby. We also have these. These are multivitamin one a day chewable tablets. You won't start these until after the 2 weeks is up. But this is something that's included in that bag as well. Let's see. The bag also comes with a EOS chapstick ball. The one that's like this. Our doctor said our lips will be very dry after the surgery. So definitely got that. I'm glad they put that in there as well. This comes in the bag as well. And this is just biotin dry mouth. And about that. Glad I pulled this out. So your breath gonna be stanky, sister or brother. Your breath gonna stink. So this would be good for you, for real. So not only will your mouth be dry, but it might be a little funky. So this right here, and it's gentle mint, so it's not like it's like spraying Listerine in your mouth. But it's definitely gonna make your mouth create water, saliva, and also give you a better smell too. Cause yeah. Let's see here. This also came in the bag, gas relief. Your main pain coming out of surgery, yes, your incisions will hurt. You know, you'll have that pain, but your main pain is going to be gas. When you have the surgery, they fill your body and your stomach up with gas to see your entire stomach and to know exactly where to cut. So most of your pain is going to be from all that trapped gas inside of you that still need to come out. And they said the best way to get it out is by walking. So I'm going to try that too. But I got my gas relief too. So I'm definitely going to be using it before I leave the hospital. Or if I have to stay overnight, definitely going to be chewing on these tablets. I know y'all probably think, well, that's a tablet. You got to chew it up like completely before you swallow it. And I think that was all that came in the bag from the medical mall. But I do already have my prescriptions for surgery as well. I have some antibiotic for, well, no, this is actually Zofran. Excuse me. This is Zofran, and I take it every 4 hours as needed. They did give me 2 refills. So I definitely do have Zofran for whenever I feel nauseous or anything like that. Let's see what else we got, y'all. Oh, and tonight, my other prescription is a liquid pain reliever. It's Oxy. I don't know the entire, but y'all know what Oxy is. You know what Oxy is, girl or boy. But definitely got my Oxy in the fridge already. And then the other prescription is an antibiotic. So those are the 3 prescriptions that my doctor prescribed me and instructed me to get before surgery. So I definitely already got those. I'm ready for those. Now that I'm prepping for surgery, because this is the night before, you have to shower twice with Happy Cleanse. They'll provide you with this. You don't have to go out and buy it or anything like that. So tonight before I go to bed, I have to take a shower with this, leave it on for about 5 minutes, then rinse it off, and also go to bed in fresh sheets. My sheets in the washer right now. You could probably hear the washer in the background, so that's why. But mind your business, sister. But yeah, definitely got this. And when I wake up in the morning, before I actually go for the procedure, I have to take another shower in this as well. And this is called Happy Cleanse. Y'all, that's all I got for y'all right now. This is the start of a new life. I'm extremely excited. I feel every emotion you can possibly feel. I'm happy. I'm scared. I'm excited. I'm nervous. I'm everything you can think of. I'm everything. And I'm sad, too. Because I had bought my boyfriend a salad from Zaxby's, and it was smelling so good. So I can only imagine how this is going to be the next 2 weeks, and I can't eat. Like, I'm really not going to be able to eat, y'all. That's really going to bother me. I'm going to figure something out, though. Y'all stay tuned. Continue to check in with your girl. I'm going to keep y'all updated week by week. I'm going to let y'all know. The starting weight is 263.4. So, we're starting off at 263.4. I ain't never been shamed by nothing, period. Like I said, I'm giving it to y'all raw, uncut, and everything else. But that's the starting weight. Hopefully, next week when I check in, we have a difference. If not, we're still going to be on the journey, so it really don't matter. Like, comment, subscribe, and don't forget to click the notification bell to get alerted every time I start a video. Peace out. Good morning, y'all. It is surgery day. I just woke up and finished my second shower with Happy Cleanse. I feel great. I'm still nervous. My face might look a little ashy because you can't put no lotion or nothing on, girl. But yes, I am on the way to the hospital. I'm going to finish my 20-ounce Gatorade. And I'm on the way to the hospital, baby. It is currently 5:15. My mom and grandma just arrived, so they're outside waiting as well. Yeah, I'll catch back up with y'all later. It's surgery day, baby. Surgery, guys. I'll look up with y'all when we get out of recovery.
All right, I'm gonna get y'all rolling off. Welcome to the Skinny Club in the Lacquer.
I'm going for the extra smile.
Okay.
Oh my God.
You what? All right, love you.
Love you more.
Try to take a nice deep one. There you go. That's better. Just do one more for me. Same way you just did it. Very good. Alright. We'll work on that a little bit more in a little bit, okay? You got your button.
I don't think I hit it back.
I don't even know where
it is. Oh, there it is. I hung it right there.
There's that button for you, okay?
I'm going to see if 30's computer is working with me.
Is that okay right there? Okay. If you need anything, you just give us a call, okay? You want to try to sit up? I know.
Guys, this is me right after surgery. The pain was literally unbearable and the anesthesia was whooping my ass, y'all. Like, I could not wake up for anything, literally. I was talking with my eyes closed, trying to wake up. I just couldn't do it. And like I told y'all earlier, walking is the best way to get rid of the gas pain. 100% agree with that. I definitely felt better the more I walked. And these are my 4 incisions. The largest incisions right there has a little speck of blood. That's where my stomach actually came out of.
So, I had surgery yesterday. I could not personally record yesterday. I was in so much pain. Still in a little bit of pain. As you've seen in the clips before this, like, you have to walk like a couple hours after surgery. That was probably one of the hardest things I had to do. The pain is, you know, I ain't never had kids, so I can't say it's equivalent to having a child, but it's literally something I have never, ever, ever experienced in my life. Like, and the anesthesia, like, knocked me out for hours. I could not wake up for anything. It was just, oh my God, it was... Y'all, I'm telling you, just be prepared. Like, this really has to be something that you really want. And it was something that I really wanted. And I've been wanting it for quite some time now. I'm going to post pictures of my scars. They'll be right here on the side. I have 4 incisions. 3 of them are about 2 to 3 centimeters. The other one is about 1 to 1.5 inch. That's where they actually pulled my stomach out of. I'll post pictures of that too if y'all want it. Viewer discretion will be advised. But yes, your girl is at home. I got to come home the same day. I've just been on my medicines, drinking a little teacup of water, and also doing my breathing exercises. With this right here, I have to breathe all the way up to the green line. I have my mom, my grandma, and my boyfriend here, so definitely have a great support system. I've just been walking around my house to get my walking in. But yeah, your girl made it, and I'm gonna check back in with y'all next Monday so we can get our weekly update. And to see how much weight we're gonna lose in 1 week, y'all. Hope y'all enjoyed this video. If you're interested in having weight loss surgery, you're on the fence about it, I strongly suggest you watch my journey. I'm going to give you the unfiltered, raw truth about VSG surgery. And as of right now, on day 2, your girl finally starting to sound back like herself, because baby, I could barely even talk yesterday, hurt so bad. And I'm still in, you know, a little bit of pain. It's slowly fading away. The only pain I'm having right now is where they pulled my stomach out of. That is where I'm having majority of my pain. However, right out of surgery, all of the gas was in my shoulders, my neck, my back, and everything else, y'all. It was horrible. But like I said, it does get better. The more you walk, the better it gets, literally. Like, the gas was, like, almost gone before I even left the hospital. So, definitely follow your doctor's instructions. And follow my journey. If you're interested in having weight loss surgery and you just want an inside look, follow my journey, sister. Add me on Instagram, TikTok, and Snap. I leave all of my information down below. And, yeah, I'll see y'all next Monday to get an update. Today is 12:25. Look at me, 12:25. 1:25. I had my surgery yesterday on January 24th. Today is the 25th. I'll check back in with y'all next week to see our weekly update. Thank y'all. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let's get this thing rolling, y'all. VSG Journey, week 1, loading.